Our primary goals are to do captive propagation and holding of freshwater mussels and other aquatic species. So we can take those animals and we can propagate them and create more individuals to bolster wild populations so that those animals persist and continue and don't decline in the wild. A mussel is a bivalve. It's an invertebrate, and they can live in marine environments or freshwater environments like the ones that we work on here. The United States is the most biologically diverse place in the world for freshwater mussels. And North Carolina has over 60 different species of freshwater mussels, which is really, really high. Freshwater mussels are important because they serve at the base of the food web. They provide a variety of ecosystem services. They filter our water for us. They take out all the algae and suspended particulates, and then they deposit that into the bottom of the river. They also help stabilize the bottom of the river. And they're also very sensitive taxa. So if we have poor water quality, they're one of the first species you see disappear out of a system. So they're indicators of good water quality, and they also help keep our rivers and our streams healthy by filtering the water as well. So the mussels are really efficient at filtering the water. And so they use the cilia on their foot and on their gills to create a current to draw in the algae and suspended particulates. So this is a wild Carolina hill splitter. The hatchery serves as a refugium for this species, and then we'll propagate this species and try to find places to put individuals back out in the wild. So this tub, which just looks like a tub full of sand, is actually home to the Tar River spiny mussel. So for the last 15 years, the Wildlife Resources Commission has been doing surveys to collect and restore the Tar River spiny mussel. There are approximately 19 mussels in this tub, which constitutes most of the known wild adult of the species left in the world. There's likely stems still out in the wild that we haven't been able to detect, but these are the 18 to 19 Tar River spiny mussels that we've been able to collect and brought back into a captive broodstock and into captive propagation. The population's densities are so low in the wild that the species is no longer able to spawn in the wild. So we have to collect them and concentrate them in a captive setting so that they can spawn and reproduce. So each mussel that comes into the hatchery receives what we call a hall print or a shellfish tag. This way we can track the individuals, track their longevity, their growth, their survival, and keep track of where they've come from and where they go. This is the yellow lance. We're also holding this species from the Tar River. These are adults, and this species was just federally listed as threatened. And so we work with our partners at NC State University to propagate this species. This is the wavy rayed lanten mussel. This species creates a darter-like lure to convince the fish to come and take a bite. So mussels have a foot, but they really can't get around very well. So they have to convince their host to come to them. And they do that by using mimicry. So this mussel is actually created as a portion of its mantle, this lure. And it will pulse this lure in an active strategy to go fishing. So one of the ways that we do propagation is by growing our mussels in our reservoir. So for the critically endangered and threatened animals, we keep them under a roof. But for more common species, we'll actually move them out to this pond and we can take a year off of our production time. And these are upwellers. So this is a compressed air line and it drives air into the standpipe. And as the air bubbles up, it pulls water through two screens. And then there are mussels in between the screens. The reason that this kind of culture works so well is because they stay in the nice warm photo layer of the pond where it's rich in algae and it's nice and warm. And so these guys are getting ready to be stocked. This is the wavy rayed lanten mussel. They have black dot tags so that once we put them out, we'll be able to track them in the wild and see how they're doing. It's important to tag your mussels before you put them back out. So one of the ways that we do that is by actually etching a unique number into each animal before we release them. This way we can track their growth and survival in the wild and go back and do monitoring surveys and make sure that the animals that we're producing are actually going back and persisting in the streams that we stock them in. So all the mussels that we produce here go back out into North Carolina waters, primarily streams, and that will be to reestablish a new population and to restore the historical range of the species, or maybe to augment an existing population that has started to decline. Because really, we want to, you know, promote delisting and preclude listing for, you know, animals under the Endangered Species Act. But we also just want to keep common animals common. So we want to make sure that, you know, our state resources are protected for future generations.